The happiest people don't have the best of everything. They just make the best of everything they have. A very warm good morning to all my dear students. We'll now begin with our 12th session. We'll be now studying a new chapter in history from our Social Science 1 textbook. The name of the chapter is World in the 20th Century. Children, look at the map. You can see the map of the continent of Africa. Here you can see that most of the African countries share straight border lines. Now let us see why African countries share straight border lines. The Europeans partitioned the African continent at the beginning of the 20th century by drawing straight lines on the map and divided the African nations amongst themselves for exploiting the natural resources. Why do the African countries share straight border lines? The Europeans who reached Africa in search of natural resources partitioned the continent at the beginning of the 20th century. On the basis of some agreements among the European countries, they divided the African nation amongst themselves by just drawing a straight line on the map. The reason that the European nations partitioned Africa was in order to exploit the natural resources. So, why did the European nations partition Africa? This is a part of exploitation of resources by the European countries, which also occurred in other parts of the world. Now let's see what Industrial Revolution is. Industrial Revolution was a period in the 18th and 19th centuries when major changes occurred in the agricultural and manufacturing and transportation fields. These changes had a big effect on the lives of the people in England. This rapid development in technology, which helped in increasing the production through machines, helped to Industrial Revolution. The birthplace of Industrial Revolution is England. So, what is Industrial Revolution? The Renaissance in the field of science led to the invention of new machines, which brought about immense changes in the field of production. Consequently, production increased while the cost of production decreased. Such changes in the field of production ushered in the Industrial Revolution. It began in England and revolutionized production and trade. Now, let's go through capitalism. The Industrial Revolution that began in the 18th century spread from England to the other European countries. Capitalists invested in factories and hence production started increasing, which in turn led to huge profits. Thus, an economic system in which production and distribution are controlled by the capitalists with the aim of increasing profit came to be known as capitalism. So, what is capitalism? The Industrial Revolution that began in the 18th century. It gradually spread from England to the other countries of Europe. Capitalists invested in factories and production was increased. This increased their profit. The economic system in which production and distribution are controlled by the capitalists with the aim to increase their profit is known as capitalism. Now, let us study what imperialism is. Firstly, we'll go through the definition of imperialism. The flow of finance capital to the colonies is called as imperialism. So, what is imperialism? The flow of finance capital to the colonies is called as imperialism. Now, let us study the features of imperialism. Imposing a nation's political, economic, and cultural dominance on another nation is a fundamental feature of imperialism. So, what is the fundamental feature of imperialism? Imposing a nation's political, economic, and cultural dominance on another nation is the fundamental feature of imperialism. That is, the colonists imposed the dominance, that is their dominance, using legal system, administrative measures, military force, etc. Thus, the capitalist countries dominated the colonies using their exploitative powers. So, what is imperialism? The distinctive phase of flow of finance capital to the colonies is known as imperialism. Imposing a nation's political, economic, and cultural dominance was on another nation is a fundamental feature of imperialism. Colonists imposed their dominance using legal system, administrative measures, military force, etc. How did imperialism come into existence due to capitalism? Large-scale industries needed huge capital investments. Many countries were producing goods more than they needed. Since they could not accommodate the large-scale production which they were producing in their domestic markets, they were forced to search for markets in other countries in Europe, which led to competition among them. Using political power and military forces, the Europeans, who had already established trade relations with Asia, Africa, and other Latin American nations, economically exploited them. These exploited nations became the colonies of European countries, which came to be known as colonization. Thus, capitalism led to imperialism. In short, imperialism means an economically, politically, and militarily powerful nation gobbling a less powerful nation. So, how did imperialism come into existence due to capitalism? The advent of large-scale industries enhanced capital investment. Many nations produced more than they needed and more than they could accommodate in their domestic markets. This overproduction forced them to search for markets. The search for markets by the industrialized countries in Europe led to competition among them. The Europeans had already established their trade relations with Asian, African, and Latin American nations. Using political power and military forces, the European countries economically exploited these nations. Later, they became the colonies of European countries. This process is called as colonization. Many trade unions came into existence to protest against the capital exploitation. Due to the protests of the trade unions, an increase in their wages decreased the profit of the capitalist. European countries considered the colonies not only as the source of raw materials but also a market for selling their industrial products. Thus, the colonial masters started investing their capital in these colonies. Now, let us study the factors that forced the capitalist countries to invest their capital in the colonies. So, first one is cheap labor. It was easy for the capitalists to get laborers at cheap prices in Asian, African, and Latin American colonies. Moving on to the availability of raw materials. Raw materials were easily available in these colonies because they were exploited by the European nations. Low costs involved in manufacturing and selling goods in colonies. Capitalists could manufacture goods at a low cost through machines and used to sell these goods in the markets of the colonies. Now, let's see how did imperialism affect the colonies. So, firstly, traditional economic system of the colonies were destroyed. So, capitalists used political and military powers and economically exploited the colonies. Secondly, administrative and judicial systems were replaced. For the convenience of the capitalist countries, they made new administrative policies and judicial laws in these colonies. Third one, people in the colonies were forced to cultivate cash crops in lieu of traditional food crops. So cash crops would fetch immediate money, and so the people in the colonies were forced to cultivate cash crops instead of the food crops. Here, cash crop means an agricultural crop which is grown to sell for profit. Say for example, cotton, coffee, sugarcane, etc. Now going on to food crops are mainly food supply. They are derived from plants. Food crops consists of grains, vegetables, fruits, etc. Moving on to the next, poverty and unemployment increased. Poverty and unemployment increased due to low production of food crops. As a result, poverty increased. Due to the usage of more and more machines, unemployment in the colonies increased. Natural resources were widely exploited. Minerals, forests, and other raw materials were highly exploited from these colonies to maximize the production. Then, indigenous arts, literature, language, culture, and education system were destroyed. The traditional art, literature, language, and the educational system in the colonies were destroyed by these Europeans. Thus, imperialism affected the colonies to such an extent that competitions and conflicts among the imperialist nations for colonies and markets led to the outbreak of wars. Find out the reasons behind the conflicts among the imperialist powers that untimely led the entire world to war. So, competition among the European nations with each in establishing colonies led to conflicts. Mutual distrust. Now, what is mutual distrust? It means no trust among themselves, and finally led to enmity. These colonies, these conflicts among themselves led to signing of military alliances. Now, let's see what an alliance is. Alliance is an union of association formed based on mutual benefit with similar interests, nature or qualities between the countries or organizations. So, find out the reasons behind the conflicts among the imperialist powers that untimely led the entire world to a war. The European nations vied with each other in establishing colonies. This competition led to conflicts among them and caused mutual distress and enmity. This further drove the nations to the signing of military alliances. Now we have two military alliances here. They are Triple Alliance and Triple Entente. These were the examples of such military alliances. So which are the two alliances? Triple Alliance and Triple Entente. What are they? Triple Alliance and Triple Entente. So we already said there are two alliances. Which were they? They were Triple Alliance and Triple Entente. Which are they? Triple Alliance and Triple Entente. Now, Triple Alliance comprised of countries namely Germany, Austria-Hungary and Italy. So, Triple Alliance comprised of which three countries? Germany, Austria-Hungary and finally Italy. So, Triple Alliance comprises of Germany, Austria-Hungary and Italy. Moving on to Triple Entente, they are England, France and Russia. So, England, France and Russia came under Triple Entente. Now, these alliances, which were the two alliances? Triple Alliance and the Triple Entente. So, these alliances created a war atmosphere in Europe. They started manufacturing and buying lethal weapons. Now, what are lethal weapons? Lethal weapons are harmful weapons used for destruction. The European nations used these various strategies in order to win the imperialistic greed. Aggressive nationalism was adopted, wherein aggressive nationalists considered their own countries as supreme in order to invade other countries. Now, what do you mean by aggressive? We already know aggressive means violence or violent by nature. Nationalism means loyalty and devotion to one's own nation. So, the formation of such alliances, which were the alliances? Triple Alliance comprised of Germany, Austria-Hungary and Italy. Triple Entente comprised of England, France and Russia. So these alliances created a war atmosphere in Europe. They started manufacturing and buying lethal weapons. The European nations resorted to various strategies to succeed in their imperialistic competitions. Aggressive nationalism was one among them. The European nations used aggressive nationalism to invade other countries. Aggressive nationalists considered their own nations as the supreme and justified, whatever be the actions of their nations. Various movements in Europe, such as Pan-Slav, Pan-German, revenge movement, were an offshoot of aggressive nationalism. Thus, it was the aggressive nationalism that led to several movements in Europe. They were first one as Pan-Slav movement. What is the first one? Pan-Slav movement. So, Pan-Slav movement began in the 19th century advocating the political and cultural union of Slavic nations and people of Serbia, Bulgaria, Greece in Eastern Europe under the leadership of Russia. So what is Pan-Slav movement? Russia wanted to unite the Slavic people of Serbia, Bulgaria, Greece, etc. in Eastern Europe under her leadership. What is here her? Her is Russia. For this, the Pan-Slav movement was formed with the help of Russia. Moving on to our second aggressive nationalism movement, which was Pan-German movement. Pan-German movement was an ideological and political movement promoting the unification of all German-speaking people of Europe. This movement was formed under the leadership of Germany. Pan-Slav movement established dominance in Central Europe and Balkan provinces like Serbia, Bosnia, Slovenia, etc. Germany planned to unite the Teutonic people. People of Germany were also known as Teutonic people. So, Pan-German movement to establish its dominance in Central Europe and Balkan provinces, Germany planned to unite the Teutonic people. This Pan-German movement came into being under the leadership of Germany. And finally, the revenge movement. This movement was formed under the leadership of France to regain Alsace-Lorraine, the territories which were occupied by Germany in 1871. So, the revenge movement in 1871, Germany occupied Alsace-Lorraine, the territories that were under the control of France. To regain these territories, the revenge movement was formed under the leadership of France. So, the imperialist rivalry drove the European countries into the several crises, among which the Moroccan crisis and the Balkan crisis are considered to be important. So, thus, European countries faced many crises due to imperialistic conflicts in which two crises are considered to be important. They are moving on to the first important crisis, which was Moroccan crisis. Now, Morocco is situated in the northwest part of Africa. It overlooks Mediterranean Sea to the north and the Atlantic Ocean to the west, with land borders with Algeria to the east and Western Sahara to the south. In 1904, a secret treaty was signed between Britain and France. Britain recognized the claim of France over Morocco. In return, Germany sent battleships to Agadir, the Moroccan port. France agreed to transfer a part of French Congo. Congo means colony, to Germany. So France agreed to transfer a part of French Congo to whom? To Germany. Thus, Germany agreed to concede Morocco to France in return. Now, what do you mean by concede? Concede means agreeing that something is true after first denying or resisting it. Although the problem was solved temporarily, rivalry continued. So, first one as Moroccan crisis, a secret treaty was signed between Britain and France in 1904. According to this, Britain recognized the claim of France over Morocco. The French claim over Morocco was opposed by Germany, which sent battleships to the Moroccan port Agadir. France agreed to transfer a part of French Congo to Germany, and Germany agreed to concede Morocco to France in return. Thus, the problem was solved temporarily. However, their rivalry continued. Moving on to our second important crisis, which led to the imperialist rivalry, was Balkan crisis. Balkan region is located in Europe, which is close to Aegean Sea and Black Sea, which was a part of Ottoman Empire. In 1912, Balkan League was comprised of Greece, Bulgaria, Serbia, Montenegro defeated Turkey. This led to the conflicts in sharing the benefits of war, which led to the break of the league and resulted in wars among them. So, moving on to Balkan crisis, the Balkan region is situated in Europe, close to the Aegean Sea and the Black Sea. It was a part of the Ottoman Empire. In 1912, Balkan League defeated Turkey. We already said that Balkan League comprised of Greece, Bulgaria, Serbia and Montenegro. So, in the Balkan League defeated Turkey in the year 1912. However, the conflict among the allied nations in sharing the benefits of the war led to the breakups of the league and resulted in wars among them. So, thus, Moroccan crisis and Balkan crisis led to imperialist rivalry. Now, let us move to the immediate causes for the outbreak of First World War. With the support of Germany, Austria laid its claim over Balkan region. With the support of Russia, Serbia claimed the Balkan region. So, with the support of Germany, Austria laid its claim over Balkan region, and with the help of Russia, Serbia claimed the Balkan region. A Serbian youth, Gavrilo Princip, assassinated Francis Ferdinand. Now, what do you mean by assassination? Assassination means murder. Francis Ferdinand was the heir to the throne of Austria. He was assassinated at the Bosnian capital Sarajevo in July 1914. Austria blamed Serbia for the assassination of Francis Ferdinand and declared a war on Serbia on 28th of July 1914. So it was Gavrilo Princip who assassinated, whom he did assassinate? Francis Ferdinand. And as a result, Austria blamed Serbia for the assassination of Francis Ferdinand and thus declared a war on Serbia on 28th of July 1914. All the allied nations rushed to help their allies and were directly or indirectly involved in the conflict, which led to the First World War. So, what was the immediate cause for the outbreak of the First World War? When Austria laid its claim over Balkan region with the support of Germany, Serbia claimed its region with the support of Russia. During this time, a Serbian youth, Gavrilo Princip, assassinated Francis Ferdinand, the heir to the throne of Austria, at the Bosnian capital Sarajevo in July 1914. Austria held Serbia responsible for it and declared a war on Serbia on 28th of July 1914. The allied nations rushed to help their allies. almost all the nations of the world were directly or indirectly involved in it. Therefore, this war is known as the First World War. Now, let us study the aftermath of the First World War. Now, what do you mean by aftermath? Aftermath means the consequences or after effects of the war. So, here we are going to study about the after effects of the First World War. More than 10 million people lost their lives or were injured in the First World War. People started starving as agriculture, industry and communication system were destroyed. Poverty, unemployment and rise in prices increased. Even the economy of Europe started declining. Many freedom movements became stronger in Asia and Africa to liberate themselves in order to many freedom movements became stronger in Asia and Africa to liberate themselves in order to bring world peace. The League of Nations came into existence. So, aftermath of the First World War. The First World War ended in 1918. So, when did the First War came to an end? It was in the year 1918. It produced far-reaching impact across the world. Now, which were they? Over 10 million people lost their lives or were injured in the war. So, how many people lost their lives? Nearly 10 million people lost their lives and many were injured in the war. Agriculture, industry and communication system were destroyed. Poverty, unemployment and inflation increased. Inflation means rise in prices. Economic dominance of Europe diminished. Diminished means declined. Liberation movements in Asia and Africa strengthened. Liberation means to get freedom. So freedom movements in Asia and Africa strengthened. In a bid to bring about peace in the world, League of Nations was formed. So after the First World War, which ended in the year 1918, in order to bring peace in the world, which was the league that was formed? It was League of Nations that came into existence to bring world peace after the end of the First World War in the year 1918. Now, let us study why was the Treaty of Versailles signed and when. The First World War ended in the year 1918. After destruction, people wanted peace. Thus, a peace conference was convened at Paris in 1919 under the leadership of the winning allies of Britain and France. The Versailles Treaty signed with Germany in 1919 was the most important treaty signed with the defeated nations. According to the Treaty of Versailles, German colonies were divided among the victorious power and Germany was forced to pay a huge amount of war penalty. Moreover, the winning allies occupied the rich mines of Germany. Thus, Germany was blamed and was made guilty and was also disarmed. Now, what do you mean by disarmed? Disarmed means not allowing to use weapons. So, the Treaty of Versailles was an example of the vengeance against the defeated nations. Discuss. Vengeance means to take a revenge. A peace conference was convened at Paris in 1919 to discuss the post-war situation under the leadership of the winning allies, which were Britain and France. They signed different treaties with the defeated nations. Among these treaties, the Versailles Treaty signed with Germany in 1919 was the most important one. According to this treaty, German colonies were divided among the victorious powers and Germany was forced to pay a huge amount as war indemnity. Indemnity here means what? What does indemnity mean? It means penalty. The Allies occupied the rich mines of Germany. Above all, the war guilt was imposed on Germany and was disarmed. Here, the United States of America was not affected by the First World War because United States of America did not participate in the First World War. As many countries lost its economy during the First World War, these European nations managed to get loans from the United States of America. The American dollar overtook the British pound as the basis of foreign exchange holdings. Thus, America emerged as a new economic power outside Europe. So, how did America become economically powerful after the First World War? The United States of America was not affected by the war. Hence, the European nations managed to get loans from the United States. Consequently, American dollar overtook British pound as the basis of the foreign exchange holding. As a result, the United States of America emerged as a new economic power outside Europe. Now, let us see how economic depression in America affected the economy of other nations. In 1929, the world was thrown into economic crisis which originated in the United States of America. This crisis very widely affected the different nations of the world because it was the United States of America who was providing loans to the other European nations, as United States of America was not affected by the First World War because it did not participate in the war. So here they were, due to economic depression, people became poorer and poorer and could not afford the goods and services that they needed or required. Factories were not able to sell their finished products. European nations who had taken loans from America were unable to repay their debts. Banks could not work and thus collapsed. Prices of the essential commodities became very high and the people could not buy them. There were widespread unemployment and poverty due to economic depression. Thus, in order to overcome these crises, the European nations imposed heavy taxes on these colonies. This economic crisis of the imperialist nations became a burden to the colonies. So, find out how the economic depression in the United States of America affected the economy of other nations and prepare a note. The economic growth of the United States of America did not last long. The world was thrown into economic crisis in 1929, which originated in the United States of America. So when did the world experience the Great Depression? It was in the year 1929. Now, the impacts of this economic depression were: people who became pauper because of the war could not afford the commodities. Goods were kept unsold in the factories. European nations failed to repay their debts to the United States of America. Banks collapsed. Inflation became uncontrollable. Acute unemployment and poverty prevailed. To overcome this crisis, the European nations adopted a strategy for imposing heavy taxes on the colonies because the Europeans needed money. And since the world was experiencing economic depression, as a result, the Americans were unable to provide loans. And hence, the only way for the Europeans to get money was to impose heavy taxes on their colonies. Therefore, the economic crisis of imperialist nations became a burden to the colonies. Let us now move on to our assessment area. Answer these questions in your notebook. Question 1. What were the impacts of economic depression after the First World War? I repeat, what were the impacts of economic depression after the First World War? Second question. What were the far-reaching impacts or aftermath of the First World War? I repeat, what were the far-reaching impacts or aftermath of the First World War? Children, that's all for today. I hope I was clear to you in my session. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.